Sheba went to Jerusalem because she wanted to test Solomon's legendary wisdom. She came to Solomon's court with a vast retinue of dancers, musicians, and attendants, and she brought with her an array of elaborate and sophisticated gifts. Solomon was greatly impressed, but most of all, he was stunned by the dazzling beauty of the queen, because she was indeed the most beautiful woman he had ever seen. "King Solomon," said the queen, "I am told that you are the wisest king in the world. Then surely you would not object to guessing three riddles for me?" "Of course not," said Solomon. So the queen started. "It grows in the field. It is the pride of the rich, but the shame of the poor. An adornment for the dead, but a threat to the living. It delights the birds, but it's a cause of mourning for the fish." Without hesitation, King Solomon said, "Flax. Exquisite linen clothes enhance the distinction of the rich, but linen rags are the shame of the poor. The dead are wrapped in a linen shroud, but the flaxen noose in the gallows is a threat to the living. The birds love flax because they eat its seeds, but the fish hate it because they are caught in flaxen nets." A murmur of amazement ran throughout the court, and the queen said, "That is the correct answer. And now, what water comes neither from heaven nor from the flowing mountain streams? It may be sweet as honey or bitter as salt, yet it flows from the same source." Again, without hesitation, King Solomon said, "Tears. For tears are neither from heaven nor from the mountain streams. When people are happy, their tears are sweet, but when they are sad, they are bitter." Again, a murmur of amazement ran throughout the court, and the queen said, "That is the correct answer." And now she called two of her attendants, who placed two identical vases of flowers in front of King Solomon. And the queen said, "Your Majesty, only one of these vases holds flowers from nature's garden. The other contains flowers crafted by my skillful attendants. And now please choose among these two vases the one that contains the real flowers." Now King Solomon realized that if he didn't identify the true bouquet, he would lose his noble title as the wisest king in the world. His reputation was at stake. So he looked intently at the vases, admired their beauty, and looked for the flaw that would reveal the false bouquet. But every green stem and bright bloom, every ivory gardenia and velvety rose petal was perfectly matched. He kept looking at the flowers, and then he saw a dewdrop on one of the rose petals, and he was going to choose the true flowers when he saw an identical droplet in the second bouquet. With patience and humility, Solomon examined the flowers. Everyone in the court was waiting for his reply, and right then a bee flew from one of the windows. One of the guards went to chase it, but Solomon said, Don't harm the bee. Let it fly at leisure. Now the bee was naturally drawn to the flowers. King Solomon started smiling because he knew that the bee was not going to be fooled by the artisan's skills. Without hesitation, the bee landed right in the middle of the left bouquet. And now Solomon chose the true flowers. The Queen of Sheba bowed to him, recognizing that he was indeed the wisest king in the world. And Solomon's wisdom endured because he knew how to listen to God's teachings. He knew that even if it is a tiny bee sent to instruct him, the wise thing to do is to listen.